Hello friends, welcome back to another episode of Engineering Today, and I hope you're all having a great time. We've got breaking news from space journalist Adrian Beil that the FAA will not require an investigation for SpaceX Starship Flight 4. The FAA has reviewed the SpaceX Starship Flight 4 mission and determined that all flight events for both Starship and Super Heavy were within the planned and authorized activities. The FAA recently approved a license modification for Starship Flight 4, which allows multiple flights of the same vehicle configuration and mission profile. If SpaceX wants to change the mission profile or make other changes that impact safety analyses, it'll need to request another license modification. As we all know, SpaceX recently achieved significant milestones with Booster 11 and Ship 29 on the fourth flight of their Starship program. As engineers prepare for the next mission, they're making several improvements based on the lessons learned, particularly to the thermal protection system. Elon Musk has suggested that the next flight could be as soon as a month away, but before that, stronger tiles need to be reapplied to ensure better protection. On launch day, expectations were high. SpaceX aimed for a soft splashdown of Booster 11 and successful heat resistance for Ship 29 during reentry. During the ascent, one of the engines, Engine 15, in the outer ring of Booster 11 shut down, which was a deviation from previous flights where all 33 engines operated. However, this did not hinder the booster's ascent, and it continued without further issues. Ship 29 continued its journey with a nominal suborbital insertion, meaning it followed the correct trajectory. Meanwhile, Booster 11 prepared for an initial landing burn by starting its inner 13 engines, then switched to the inner 3. However, shortly after ignition, Engine 8 exploded. Despite this, Booster 11 continued and became the first Super Heavy booster in the Starship program to complete a landing in the Gulf of Mexico. After the engine shut down, Booster 11 tipped over and sank into the sea. As Ship 29 entered the atmosphere at over 26,000 kilometers per hour, it started to glow with plasma due to the extreme friction heating the air. This was the first time re-entry plasma was seen live from external cameras. Ship 29 successfully navigated peak heating, achieving one of its primary objectives. However, the starboard forward flap's bottom actuation arm melted off, and the plasma damaged it significantly. Despite the damage, Ship 29 successfully completed re-entry. It then performed a flip-and-burn maneuver, successfully landing in the ocean and tipping over intact. This mission provided valuable data and highlighted areas for improvement as SpaceX continues to advance the Starship program. On the other hand, the Federal Aviation Administration is working on an environmental impact statement related to SpaceX's request for a commercial launch vehicle operator license. This license would allow SpaceX to use Launch Complex 39A at Kennedy Space Center in Florida. SpaceX also plans to construct launch and landing sites near LC-39A to facilitate the launch and landing of their Super Heavy booster and Starship. The FAA statement is necessary because the National Environmental Policy Act considers issuing a vehicle operator license and approving airspace closures as significant federal actions. Therefore, the FAA needs to evaluate the potential environmental impacts of these actions. The FAA is leading this review and has invited the public to share their input on the matter. As we know, recently SpaceX conducted its fourth flight test of Starship from Launch Complex 1 at Starbase in Boca Chica, Texas. Now, SpaceX is seeking federal approval to launch Starship from NASA facilities at the Kennedy Space Center in Cape Canaveral, Florida. Alongside these plans, SpaceX aims to expand its Hangar X site at the Roberts Road area of Kennedy Space Center by 100 acres, an area that's already undergone an environmental review. The FAA published a notice of intent to prepare the environmental impact statement on May 10th and is encouraging people and entities to submit comments online through the federal e-rulemaking portal by June 24th. The FAA will review all submitted comments as part of their evaluation process. To facilitate public involvement, the FAA has conducted several meetings. There were two in-person public meetings on last Wednesday at the Radisson Cape Canaveral and another on Thursday at the Kennedy Space Center Visitor Complex on Merritt Island, Florida. Information and materials used at the in-person meetings, such as display boards and fact sheets, are available online in both English and Spanish. This effort is part of the FAA's commitment to ensure that the public is well-informed and has the opportunity to provide feedback on SpaceX's proposed activities. And now, SpaceX is gearing up for its fifth flight with the Starship system, and preparations are advancing smoothly. The booster from the last flight landed successfully, so significant changes aren't necessary for the next mission. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk has confirmed that they plan to catch Booster 12 during Flight 5. While the booster performed well overall, there were issues with the engines. One failed during ascent, and another exploded during the landing burn. SpaceX will conduct internal investigations to identify the causes of these problems. Booster 12 has been stationed in Mega Bay 1 since January 23, 2024, awaiting its static fire test. Currently, there's no set date for this test, as SpaceX is focused on removing the hold-down clamps on the orbital launch mount, OLM, a prerequisite step before the static fire can proceed. Though Ship 29 encountered several challenges during its flight, as a result, Ship 30 is undergoing substantial updates. Its heat shield tiles and underlying blankets are being removed and replaced. The new underlying material might be an ablative material first used on Ship 29. Elon Musk mentioned that the tiles are being upgraded to a stronger design. Despite completing the flip-and-burn maneuver, Ship 29 missed its target by a few kilometers due to flap damage. The Federal Aviation Administration reviewed SpaceX's fourth Starship flight and found that all operations were within the planned and authorized scope. Since there were no major incidents, SpaceX is cleared to proceed with Flight 5. However, the current license might not cover the booster catch at the launch site, so SpaceX may need to modify its license. And that's all for now. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.